You see, for instance, in marriage, I want to use marriage to illustrate. I hope you understand what I'm doing here. For instance, in marriage, when it comes to relationship, most guys are looking for already made men. God is a husband man, say that everybody. So God is an agriculturalist, that's the meaning. So what does agriculturalists do? Planters, farmers, they look for seed. If they're looking for fruit like orange, like pear, like cassava, they plant what can produce that thing. What they look for is the potential that give birth to that fruit. That kind of wife you are looking for, that perfect woman, that woman without wrinkles and without spots, without blemish, without shortcomings, if she is alive, she would have been killed. The only perfect man that ever lived was killed because of his perfection. And his name is called Jesus. Can I go further? So you're looking for a wife. What God will do for you, will present you a woman who has potential for the fruits you are looking for. So with patience and long suffering, you turn her to become the woman of your dream you fantasize in your heart. If you are looking for a finished product, that person is already somebody's wife. I need to come down here. And that person's wife that you want that girl to become took that man 20 to 30 years to produce. They heard me. So it took 20 years to turn her to a brand. So you look for the woman that has potential for what you are looking for. You say, I am looking for a pastor. She has it. She has character. She's the beauty, the kind of beauty you want. Most of you like yam legs or slim legs. Or... you know, our specs are different. Most of you like slim, bullet that can shoot you, some shubby. This, once she locks into your expectation and the potentials are there, as a farmer, start removing all the attitude with patience, with patience, with patience. With patience, with patience, with patience, and long suffering. Then you start dressing her. You put manure inside. You irrigate her. Along the line, one day you will wake up. You realize that you have pear fruit. But what you got before was pear seed. You are looking for a man to marry. Most sisters say, men are scarce. There are no men. No, 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 no. Not for a sister who has this knowledge. You want to marry. You, for a sister, you don't pick one guy. No. You look, you those guys that are surrounding you, that potentials, start contributing to their development, to their improvements. Men don't care how great you are until they see how much you support their mission. And one of the greatest needs of every man is one word called peace. So men don't care how you look, they don't care. Just give them peace, that's all they want. Because they are strong enough to drive anything. But they want peace of mind to drive their mission. And to give the world the products God has instill in your hearts. Are you see here? So the guys around you, hello Cynthia, what's up? Hello Janet, hello. Don't stop looking for a husband. And it's just like somebody 6 months old. You say, if you don't marry now, 6 months old guy, if you don't marry and give me children, I'll kill you. That's what you are doing. Friends are around you now. They are not yet mature. They are 6 months, some 1 year. It will take time for them to mature. Everything. When such may finally grow up, when they become the trees, and they are looking for somebody to cover, it's you they will look for. So while you are looking for husband everywhere, husbands are around you in form of seeds. They don't have job yet. They are not standing well yet. They are not. They've not even got the direction yet. So but still dirty. What's your job? You start watering. You see the seed. He said, this guy is going somewhere. Let me contribute. Once in a while, you just go, you buy a CD plate, a kit for you, book for you. You are not professing love. You see yourself as a helper around their lives. The reason church people, church ladies pray for husbands is because they don't water anyone to be great. It's a bank manager. It's a bishop. It's a this. The wife will be patiently watching that seat, dressing that seat, and the man is the envy of four ladies. You pick one's potential too and groom. You will pray for husband. Yes, I hear. Yeah. The guy has some character challenge. I can't take it. Then why is God grooming you? Why are you a prepared lady? Why are you a woman of character? The reason you have challenge because you pick only one. Don't pick one as your husband. Not short destinies. When a farmer goes to farm, they don't plant only one seed though. They plant several seeds. Hello? Because there is one that will use yield major harvest amongst them all. If you are in this kind of business, I'm telling you, such ladies don't pray for husband. Have you noticed ladies who are very friendly, who have this social influence, and they have this helping spirit, investing guys, they marry on time. Let's be specific. Let me be sincere with you. Between the age of 20 to 23, you should know who you should marry.